If that was widely kept,
would I have at least one account in the scriptures of either the apostles or any one of the men that came up under the apostles keeping that custom? I was in that scripture because that really came about, let's not call it Christmas rather, about 400 years later, if I'm not mistaken, after the death of the Lord. So, understand? So, that day, and at the point in time, they had nothing to do with the person of the Lord.
Right.
Understand? But the years goes by, instead of finishing more with so-called Jesus, the so-called birth of the Lord.
Right.
Understand?
And basically, the scripture, everyone said, like, to keep the death as a memorial. You understand? Lord never said anything about worshiping, basically keeping the birth in remembrance. You understand? That is self-worship, like vain glory. You understand? The scripture say Yahweh Shai, it always pleases him to do the will of his Father. Not himself, he always seek the glory of his Father. You understand, bro?
I mean, let me say this. If you had to celebrate something about the Lord, you said to celebrate the Lord to celebrate. Celebrate the Lord being risen to glory.
God.
When you celebrate his birth, when he was born to be sacrificed.
God.
Celebrate the day that the Lord was exalted to glory. That is something to celebrate. Not the day the Lord born to be made as the sheep, as the sacrificial lamb.
Because the scripture say rather to rejoice when one is dead and to mourn when one is born.
Man.
And when you look up, when you say Merry Christmas with understanding, the word Mary, which is M-E-R-R-Y, means happy or joyful, and Christmas goes back to what? Christ Master, what the Master, which means death or dismissal.
Love that lesbian.
So really and truly, you really seeing happy death or happy dismissal of Christ, of the anointing, of the oil. So really and truly, they're glorying in the depth of the Lord, really and truly. Understand? They want the glory because in their mind, they tell themselves that because he's no longer here physically, that they had a time to rule and rule and to rule forever. To try to up the prophecy, they're telling that the prophecy have been upset. In other words, like how Herod wants to kill the Lord. Because you're trying to up the prophecy. It's the same thing.
Right there.
Baruch?
Yeah, God.
Verse 1? It's in Baruch chapter 4, verse 1. This is the book of the commandments of God and the law that endures forever. All that I keep it shall come to life, but such as leave it shall die.
Yeah, all that keep the laws of the Most High shall come to life. You understand? Right? Because the Most High, basically, really and truly, he had no pleasure in the death of his creation. Right? But due to envy of the devil, that is why, you understand, that came in. Right? Well,
turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of it. Walk in the presence of the light thereof, that thou mayest be illuminated.
Yeah, so that is why we out here. You understand? We tell you people basically to repent and turn back to your Baal Shem, your Shem.
That's right.
You understand? Because guess what? The things that you people are doing right about now is evil, wicked, and detestable in the Most High eyesight. Right? But you people damn blind and dumb, and you just ain't seeing it. Right?
This is John chapter 3 verse 19. And this is the condemnation, that light has come into the world and men love darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil.
Yes, the deeds were evil. Because scripture say come and be illuminated. But you people don't want to come to light. You're rather stay in darkness. Right? But guess what? All who does not worship Yahushua, Yahushua shall be put to death.
That's right.
Thus said the Most High. You understand?
For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light. He that cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest that they are wrought in God.
Because you people don't like to, you don't like when somebody come and tell you that you're doing shit. You understand? You're fully doing wrong. Right?
Because you're saying this is the tune that we start to know, right?
God,
this Acts chapter 15, verse 18. Known unto Yahweh of all his works from the beginning of the world. Wherefore my sentence is that we trouble not them which from among the Gentiles that turn to Yahweh, but that we write unto them that they abstain from pollution of idols and from fornication and from things strangled and from blood. So basically, hey, teach the body law to bring them out of
China for
that ignorant state, that Gentile state of mind. As we tell, hey, to keep from idols, worshiping Christmas, going back to worshiping of idols. You understand?
This is good. John chapter 2, verse 15. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. Any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not from the Father.
Yes,
world.
Yes, so all these things is of the world. You understand? You people out there, you have a carnal mind. But you people just study pleasure. Scripture say, loving pleasure more than worshiping the Most High. You understand? That is what you people out there doing, right? But you would not take, you people out there would not take correction. Right, you people out there won't take correction. That is why the Most High will not bow your neck to the slaughter in that time to come. Right? The Most High said, what he shall ease them of his adversaries. You understand? You people have now become the enemies of your creator, your Yahweh Shem, your Shai.
Right.
You understand? That is why the Most High will not put you people to death. Right? And some of you out there, you're basically you're trying and come and kill these men up here. But we trust in your side.
God.
That's up there.
Real quick.